On behalf of the Early Learning Center and Ms. Lindsay in her absence, who's out of training, I would just like to say thank you all for taking time out of your schedules to come to the program and to celebrate Black History with the kids. I am Brandy Johnson. I'm a senior English major here at Albany State University, and I intern in the two-year-old classroom. So we're going to go ahead and get started. First on our program, we have greetings by Mrs. Soraya Miller, the Director of Child Care Resource and Referral of Southwest Georgia.
No applause necessary. Welcome. As she said, I am Soraya Miller, the director of ASU's Go Rams Child Care Resource and Referral Agency, and very tickled and pleased to be here today to listen a few quick minutes to these wonderful children. And I did want to just take this opportunity to thank you for choosing this Early Learning Institute to enroll your child. It's more than just a child care program that operates with a license from Child Care Licensing at DeKalb in Atlanta. As you know, it's 2 stars, quality rated. And that says a whole lot for what they are able to do to ensure not just basic nurturing and protection and safety and health and food and nutrition and all that for your child, but also teaching and ensuring that your child's got the best chance possible for school success. What they do, being a 2-star quality rated facility, is create a language rich environment. They are talking, they are interacting with your children. And this is what we call developmentally appropriate practice. They employ this over there. It's learning through play. The research tells us we don't need the big fat crayons. We don't need ABCs and 1-2-3s in recitation all of the time. We need to be talking, talking, talking. What's the best nutrition language? Is talking, talking, talking. We have too many children in the state of Georgia that aren't reading on a third grade level by the time they're in third grade. These children, because you cared and you chose this Early Learning Institute, are gonna not fall into that category. And I'm so proud for what Angela and Lindsay and her staff, who are highly trained to facilitate learning through play, have been able to accomplish over there. So before I get on a soapbox about all of that, I just wanted to offer my thanks and congratulations to them. They're not far from 3 stars. That's the top rating in the state of Georgia. And just rest assured that you've done the right thing, and I applaud you for that. So without further ado, we wanna welcome these children to help us all celebrate Black History Month today. Thank you.
Next, we'll have a welcome by our Little Miss ELC, Little Miss India Walton.
February is a special month because we celebrate the achievements in the Blacks in America. Today we will showcase what we have learned about our history. Welcome and enjoy.
And now we'll get started with the class presentations. First, we have the 2-year-old class, who is taught by Mrs. Goins and Ms. Jackson.
Good morning, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to the red carpet here at the Historical Black University, Albany State University. We are here this morning to honor some hidden figures, as well as some very popular African Americans. They will be visiting us from the past, present, and future. We are glad you could join us as we meet some of our trailblazers and hear what that their black means to them. First we have coming down the red carpet is Miss Fannie Lou Hamer. She's a little old, she's taking her time. Fannie Lou Hamer, born Fannie Lou Townsend, was born October 6, 1917. She died March 14, 1977. She was an African American. She was an African American voting rights activist, civil rights leader, and philanthropist. She was instrumental in organizing Mississippi's Freedom Summer for the Student Nonviolent Coordinating Committee, SNCC, and later became the vice chair of Mississippi's Freedom Democratic Party, which she represented in the 1964 Democratic National Convention in Atlantic City, New Jersey. My black is... persistent. All right, let's give it up for Miss Fannie Lou Hamer. Next we have, getting ready to come down the red carpet, is George Washington Carver. George Washington Carver was born into slavery in Diamond, Missouri, possibly in 1864 or 1865. Though the exact date is not known, Carter's reputation is largely based on his promotion of alternative crops to cotton, such as peanuts and sweet potatoes. He wanted poor farmers to grow alternative crops both as a source of their own food and as a source of other products to improve their quality of life. He died January 5th, 1943. He was about 80 years old, and my black is...
My back is... My back is... Inventor.
Good job. Inventor. All right, next we have Miss Bessie Coleman. And Miss Bessie Coleman was born January 26, 1892. She died April 30th, 1926. She was an American civil aviator. She was the first woman of African American descent and the first of African Americans, Native Americans, to hold a pilot license. Because neither African Americans nor women had flight school opportunities in the United States, she saved up her money to go to France to become a licensed pilot. She soon became a successful air show pilot in the United States. Her pioneering role was an inspiration to early pilots and to the African American community. Miss Bessie Coleman, your black is? Strong-willed. All right, thank you. Your black is strong-willed. All right, next we have Benjamin O. Davis Jr. He was born December 18, 1912, and died July 4, 2002. He was an American United States Air Force general in command of the World War II Tuskegee Airmen. He was the first African American general in the United States Air Force. On December 9, 1998, he was advanced to four-star general by President Bill Clinton. Davis followed in his father's footsteps in breaking racial barriers as Benjamin O. Davis Sr. was the first African-American general in the United States Army. My black is... My black is...
Courageous.
All right, his black is courageous. Next, we have Maya Angelou, born Marguerite Ann Johnson. She was born April 4th, 1928, and she died May 28th, 2014. She was an American poet, memorist, and civil rights activist. She is respected as a spokesperson for black people and women, and her works have been considered as a defense of black culture. My black is...
Well spoken.
Good job. All right, I think we have some present day people getting ready to come down the red carpet now. I think I see Oprah Winfrey. There she is. Oprah Winfrey, born Oprah Gail Winfrey, January 29, 1954. She is an American media appropriator, talk show host, actress, producer, and philanthropist. Dubbed the queen of all media, she has been ranked the richest African American, the greatest black philanthropist in American history, and is currently North America's first and only multi-billionaire black person. My black is... Good job. Successful. All right, right behind her coming down the red carpet is Miss Diamond Lavish Reynolds. It's those random acts of courage that mark our place in history, such as the case with Diamond Reynolds, the fiance of Philando Castile, who was pulled over and shot to death by a police officer in an absurd act of racial profiling in July 2016. Reynolds, using Facebook Live, immediately captured Castile slowly bleeding to death. Her calm use of the word sir, and with the officer in front of her four-year-old daughter and dying boyfriend, Reynolds calmly and bravely live-streamed the aftermath so that the world could see the horror of police brutality. My black is... What is your black, Miss Reynolds?
Black!
Good job. Her black is brave. All right, next we have Jonathan Butler. He literally put his life on the line after becoming motivated by the protests in Ferguson, Missouri, and tired of repeated and ignored incidents of racial aggression on campus. University of Missouri graduate student Jonathan Butler vowed to undertake the hunger strike until the university president resigned, amongst other demands. Hundreds of students, faculty, and all races joined in support, including the school Division I football team, which vowed not to play in solidarity. University President Tim Wolf and Chancellor R. Bowen Lofton left their posts at Missouri University days later, providing that the one valiant action can in fact change the world. My black is...
A leader,
good job. All right, next we have coming down the red carpet is Miss Condoleezza Rice. She was born November 14, 1954 in Birmingham, Alabama. Miss Rice will go on to serve as the 66th United States Secretary of State. She is the first African-American Secretary of State. Miss Rice is listed number 2 on Forbes' Most Powerful Women. In September 2010, she became a faculty member of the Stanford Graduate School of Business and a director of its Global Center for Business and Economy. My black is, what is your black, Ms. Condoleezza Rice?
Helpful.
Good job, her black is helpful. All right, we have somebody who loves going down the court. We have Mr. LeBron James. He was born December 30th, 1984. He is an American professional basketball player for the Cleveland Cavaliers. James has won 3 NBA championships. He has been rated as one of America's most influential and popular athletes. And my black is...
Athletic.
Good job, LeBron James. All right, next we have Jesse Williams. He was born August 5th, 1981. He is an American actor, model, and activist, best known for winning the Humanitarian Award at the 2006 BET Awards, delivering a speech highlighting racial injustice and police brutality. And my black is... Good job. His black is courageous. All right, next we have, pick him up. It's okay. All right, next we have Mr. and Mrs. Michelle Obama. All right. We have Barack Obama, born August 4th, 1961. He is an American politician who served as the 44th President of the United States from 2009 into 2017. He was the first African-American president to serve as president, as well as the firstborn out of the contiguous United States. Next to him, by his loving side, is his wife, Michelle Yvonne Robinson Obama, born January 17, 1964. She is an American lawyer and writer who was the first lady of the United States from 2009 to 2017. She is married to the 44th president of the United States, Barack Obama, and was the first African-American first lady. Obama is a graduate of Princeton University and Harvard Law School. Barack and Michelle were married in 1992 and have two daughters. So, Mr. Barack Obama, your black is?
Hope.
Good job, Hope. And your black is Miss Obama?
Miss Obama.
My black is? All right, she said her husband can speak for her today. Thank you, Mr. and Mrs. Obama. All right, next we have Beyonce Knowles Carter, born September 4th, 1981. She is an American singer, songwriter, and actress. In 2014, she became the highest paid black musician in history and was listed among Time's 100 most influential people in the world for a second year in a row. Forbes listed her as the most powerful female in entertainment of 2015. My black is?
Your black is what?
Your black is? All right, her black is fierce. Go ahead, Beyonce. All right, so now we have coming down the red carpet some of our future trailblazers. You might not have heard of them yet, but you will soon. We have Harley Waters, born August 25th, 2014. Harley Waters has won awards in gymnastics and has even competed in the Olympics. She is known for her moves on the stage as well as she sings her heart out every night on sold-out shows. Harley enjoys traveling around the world and singing many hits to our troops. Philanthropy is her biggest pride. She says, giving is the key to success. My black is?
What is your black?
Your black is?
My black is energetic.
Good job. Her black is energetic. Another one of our future trailblazers is Logan Davis. He was born July 28th, 2014. Davis is a world-renowned doctor who serves the black community. He is a humanitarian, helping communities in poverty through donations, which help establish gardens and deliver healthy food options for those in need. Davis has helped with the research for finding cures for cancer and other diseases. He continues to educate the black community with better ways to stay and remain healthy to live a better quality of life. My black is? What is your black? Good job. His black is driven. Last but not least, we have one more soon up-and-coming trailblazer, born Dallas Rosa, born June 23rd, 2014. He is a counselor and a football player who is often seen on television from reality shows, CNN, and other talk shows. He provides people with practical ways to help be successful through every adversity they may face while being a beast on the football field. Rosa is a leader on and off the field, which he receives many endorsements. Rosa has used his platform to address many issues in the black community, risking the loss of endorsements and fans. So my black is?
What's your black?
His black is determined. He agrees. As the host of the Red Carpet Affair, I would like to say my black is resilient. The children here today will eventually become a part of our history. Their works and our acts will play a part in someone's life. Remembering, as African Americans, we have to work together to be a united front. Building each other up is the key. You, me, us, as a whole, are their role models on how to treat one another and ourselves and themselves. This concludes our red carpet affair. I would like to thank all my African American trailblazers for taking time to come visit with us, and I would also like to thank you, our viewers.
Whoa, whoa, whoa.
Let's give our two-year-olds another hand of applause. Next for the presentations, we'll have the three-year-old class, which is taught by Mrs. Lowe and Ms. Brown, and Ms. Brooks is being assisted by Ms. Lowe today.
I have a dream.
I have a dream. I have a dream. I have a dream. Said Martin Luther King. I dream that children black and white can play together and not fight. I dream that schools will be for all. I have a dream.
Keep on a talking. Keep marching up to freedom, Lansing. Oh, got it. Turn it round. Turn it round. Turn it round. We ain't gonna let it
round. Turn it round.
Keep on a walking. Keep on a talking.
Marching for the past. I'm equal. I'm a man. I'm not property. My freedom. You're my right. My hope. Give me my opportunity. Give me America. Eagle pig. My blackness. My legacy. My culture. He fight for my future. I fuck with my seeds. My sister. I am Black America.
Now the threes will do a presentation of a poem, His Dream Lives On.
His dream lives on. Today's the day we all sing in honor of Martin Luther King. Forever free from fire, till we see his baby married with dignity. When black people run free, run. He's too strong to lead the fight. But some people did not like his rest. He was taken away to a better realm. He fought with ghosts that changed people's minds and their hearts. Yet his dream lives on, that we can all be free when he knocks down the walls between you and me.
What are you thinking of? Then I guess, but his dream is better. I feel like it.
And the last presentation will come from the pre-K class, who is taught by Mrs. Selena and Mrs. Luke.
Good morning, everyone. Pre-K will present to you history from past to present.
I was born in 1955. I'm from South Carolina. I am the chairperson, CEO of BET. I am Deborah Lee.
I was born in 1954. I'm from Mississippi. I'm the first African American woman with the highest rated TV talk show. I'm my own TV network, and I'm Oprah Winfrey.
I was born as Sarah Breedlove in 1867. I live in Louisiana. I was the first self-made millionaire in America. I am Madam C.J. Walker.
I was born in the 1970s. I am from Illinois. I'm the first African-American woman to create executive a top 10 primetime TV series such as Grey's Anatomy and Private Practice. I am Shonda Rhimes.
I was born as Emmett Perry Jr. I was born in 1969. I am from Louisiana. I am an actor, comedian, and songwriter. I'm famous for the character of Madea. I am Tyler Perry.
I'm in 1942, I'm Gunn, Tennessee. I'm qualified to clean a sign, Aretha Franklin.
I was born in 1954. I was born in California.
I was born in 1958. I'm from Indiana. I'm the king of pop. I'm Michael Jackson.
I was born in 1971. I am from New York. I am a songwriter, model, and actress. I am also known as the Queen of Hip Hop, so I am Mary J. Blige.
I was born in 1925 in New York City. I'm a singer and a dancer. I love songs and talents. I'm Sam Davis.
I was born in 1928. I am from Missouri. I wrote books such as Mom and Me, Mom, Letter to My Daughter, just to name a few. I am also known for one of my favorite poems. Title is Still I Rise, I Am Maya Angela.
I was born in 1929. I am from Atlanta, Georgia. I am a leader in the civil rights movement, and I fought for racial equality for all people. I am Don Martin Luther King Jr.
I was born in 1941. I'm from South Carolina. I wrote the Lone Sign, Dr. Martin Luther King Jr. I am Jesse Jackson.
I'm from MMM, I'm the first African-American astronaut to travel to space. I am Miss Jameson.
I was born in 1918. I am from Virginia. I am a mathematician. I do technical work for NASA. I am Katherine Johnson.
I was born in 1923. I'm from Albany, Georgia. I'm from African American to win a gold medal for track and field. I am Alice Coach.
I was born in 1878. I am from Texas. I was the first. American heavyweight boxing champ, I am Jack Johnson.
I was born in the 1990s. I am from Cairo, Georgia. I was the first African American Major League Baseball player. I am Jackie Robinson.
I was born in 1950.
54. I am from I'm from Mississippi. I'm the first black child to attend all white schools in Louisiana. I am Ruby Bridge.
In small towns and in big cities, we came together as Democrats, Republicans, and Independents to stand up and say that we are one nation, we are one people, and our time for change has come.
let's give all of our classes a round of applause. And let's also give the ELC teachers a round of applause for finding it necessary to educate the children on Black history. Next, we'll have the PTO president, Dr. Latoya Jackson.
Good morning. How many of you enjoyed today's program? Absolutely amazing. Thank you so much to the Albany State Early Learning Center teachers, the staff, and also you parents, because this could not have been a success if you were not practicing at home with your child. As several of the students got to the stage, I saw mothers and fathers as they were saying the speeches with their child and make sure that they said it correctly. So you should be so proud of the success of your child today. Just a quick reminder, just wanted to let you know that remember our Sweetheart Ball is March the 11th, 2017, 4 p.m. and it's going to be at the Student Center Ballroom. If your child is running for a Little Miss Albany State University Early Learning Center or a Little Mister, make sure that Miss Lynn has your entry form. We want to make sure that we have an award for every child that is going to participate. We're also asking every parent, make sure you sell some of the raffle tickets, as well as make sure that you purchase ad. Remember, the money goes straight back to the Early Learning Center where we're able to do things for our students. We thank you so much, and we just are so excited for today's program. Thank you.
And last on our program, we'll have closing remarks by Dr. Kimberly Holmes, the director of Title III.
Good morning, everyone. Thank you. I won't make my comments very long, but I do want to thank all of the parents who took time, parents and family and friends who took time out of your schedules to join us for this beautiful program this morning. One more round of applause, if you don't mind, for the children who did just beautifully, for the teachers who did a beautiful job with the students, for the Early Learning Center staff who support Ms. Lindsay and her team. Just phenomenal work. Hopefully you see that we've taken some of the feedback you've provided to us and we're putting it into action, because this is all about the children at the end of the day. And as I'm watching the children talk about and explain what they know about some of our historical celebrities, but also persons who've really made a difference in all of our lives, it just gave me a warm feeling in my heart to know that if we set the right foundation for these children, for our children, they can do and be anything. And that's a very, very exciting thing. We don't know what the world will bring to them. We know there will be challenges, but because they have support systems in you as parents, because they have a support system in Albany State University and the Early Learning Center, they will get the foundation they need to go on to heights of excellence that we cannot yet imagine. And so we're gonna speak that over these children, that they will do and be excellent from now until the time they make their transition. So again, thank you to all of you. We appreciate you and we look forward to supporting you at the event that's coming up. I just found out about the ball this week, so please make sure I get the form to complete for an ad. I'd like to support that and support and ask everyone else in the sound of the voice to also support this ball, which the proceeds go back to support the children and strengthening our curriculum and some of the programs at the center. So again, thank you to all. Have a wonderful day. Have a great weekend.